Welcome to Chem Help ASAP. We're going to draw the orbital picture for formaldehyde. So here is formaldehyde. Formaldehyde has a double bond between the carbon and oxygen, and that consists of a sigma and a pi bond, and the pi bond is going to dominate our picture. This carbon, we'd say, is sp2 hybridized, and if you really ask me, I'd say it doesn't matter what the hybridization is for oxygen because it's a terminal atom, and hybridization is about predicting geometries and bond angles, and oxygen has neither. However, for these orbital pictures, we do need to pick a hybridization for oxygen, and we'll finalize that in a second. So we're going to draw our carbon, and we're going to do our hybridization so that we use, for our sp2 hybridization, we use px and py. We get our three sp2 hybrids. They're going to be in the xy plane because we chose to use px and py. And then we'll have a leftover pz, and that's how we'll make our pi bond. So this is what the sigma framework, the single bonds for carbon, will look like. They sit in the xy plane, representing the trigonal plane. And there's our PZ on carbon. Now, we'll work our way over to oxygen. And one thing that we know about oxygen, it must have a PZ orbital because we have to make a double bond between that oxygen and that carbon. So therefore, it's got to have a PZ orbital. The real question is, what do we do for our lone pairs? Typically, when you count for hybridization, how many hybrids you need, you include the number of lone pairs. So we will give those lone pairs hybrid orbitals, and we'll say oxygen has three hybrids. It's also sp2. And that its sp2 framework is going to sit also within the xy plane. And so we'll draw it much like we did carbon. We'll have a wedged lobe for our lone pair instead of drawing a sigma bond. And we'll have a hashed lobe for our second lone pair. And then we'll overlap our PZ orbitals and we're done. And hopefully it's clear that this structure lies within the XY plane and the P orbitals to make the pi bonds are sitting above and below that plane along the Z axis. Now, this again, the pi bond, we draw two lines for the pi bond. That is one pi bond. Two lines, it's one bond, the interaction of the lobes on the top and bottom of the molecule.